Good morning. What are the objectives of this video lesson? Means on completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know elastomers, preparation and uses of vinous rubber, preparation and uses of butyl rubber, next preparation of neoprene rubber, uses of neoprene rubbers. Next, fibers. In the fibers, we discuss about nylon 66 and uses of nylon 66. Next, polyester. Next, uses of polyester. Okay, in this video lesson, we discussed about elastomers, preparation and uses of vinous rubber, preparation of butyl rubber, uses of butyl rubber, preparation of neoprene rubber, uses of neoprene rubber, and also we discuss about fibers. Next, preparation of nylon 66, uses of nylon 66. Next, polyester, preparation of polyester. Next, uses of polyester. Now we discuss about elastomers. What about the elastomers? What are the elastomers? Vulcanizable man-made rubber like polymers are called elastomers. Vulcanizable man-made rubber like polymers are called elastomers. These are stretched to at least twice of its length. These are stretched to at least twice of its length. Next, if we remove the stretching force, returns to original shape and dimensions. Okay, returns to its original shape and dimensions as soon as stretching force is released. These are the elastomers. Okay, vulcanizable man-made rubber like polymers are called elastomers. What are the elastomers means? Okay, stretched to at least twice of its length and returns to its original shape and dimensions as soon as stretching force is released. These type of rubbers are called elastomers. Yes, elastomers are stretched to at least twice of its length and returns to its original shape and dimensions as soon as stretching force is released. Suppose rubber have this type of characters, rubber has this type of characters, that rubber is called elastomers. Okay. In the rubber bands are called elastomers. Okay. Examples of artificial rubbers are elastomers. Artificial rubbers are called elastomers. So examples of artificial rubbers are elastomers. First one, vinous rubber, butyl rubber, neoprene rubber. So we discussed one by one, vinous rubber, butyl rubber and neoprene rubber. Next, preparation of vinous rubber. Okay, vinous rubber is prepared by copolymerization of butadiene and styrene taken in 3:1 ratio. Okay, what is the addition polymerization? Same type of monomers are participated. What are the condensation polymerization? Different types of monomers participated and simple molecules are eliminated. Next, what is the copolymerization? Different type of monomers are participated but simple molecules are not eliminated. So here, this is the butadiene, this is the styrene, these are different monomers. These are participated in copolymerization, then vinous rubber is prepared. Okay, vinous rubber is prepared by copolymerization of butadiene and styrene taken in 3:1 ratio. 75-25 means 3:1 ratio. This is the reaction of preparation of vinous rubber. Okay, butadiene, this is the formula, N CH2 double bond CH bond CH double bond CH2. This is ब्यूटाडाइन और उनका मात्री ब्यूटाडाइन. नेक्स्ट दिस इज स्टाइरिन C6H5 CH double bond CH2 C6H5 means benzene ring. This is CH double bond CH2. These two are participated in 3:1 ratio. Then Buna ice rubber is prepared. So what happened here? Here double bond is broken. Here double bond is broken. This carbon forms bond with this CH. Next, this carbon forms bond with another styrene molecule. Next, this carbon forms bond with another butadiene molecules. Then, this type of structure is formed. This is the Buna S rubber. Buna S rubber. Okay. Buna S rubber is prepared by copolymerization of butadiene and styrene in the 3:1 ratio. Next, uses of Buna S rubber. In the manufacture of motor tires, Buna S rubber is used in the manufacture of motor tires. Generally, we observe motor tires. These motor tires are prepared by Buna S rubber. Next, it is used in the making floor tiles. Okay, generally, tiles are used in our houses. Okay, those floor tiles are prepared by Buna S rubber. Footwear components, that means chappals, are prepared by also Buna S rubber, mainly sole of the chappals are prepared by Buna S rubber. Next, shoe soles, that means okay. Next, wire and cable insulators are also prepared by Buna S rubber. This is electrical insulator. Buna S rubber is, so wires and cable insulators are prepared by Buna S rubber. Next, it is used in carpet baking adhesives. Okay, carpets generally are also prepared by plastic. That plastic is Buna S rubber adhesives. These are the uses of Buna S rubber. Okay, Buna S rubber is used in the manufacture of motor tires. Buna S rubber is used in making floor tiles. Buna S rubber is used in footwear components. Buna S rubber is used in shoe soles. Buna S rubber is used in wire and cable insulators. Buna S rubber is used in carpet baking adhesives. These are the motor tires. These motor tires are prepared by Buna S rubber. Okay, these are the tractor tires, all type of tires, car tires, lorry tires, bus tires, all these motor tires are prepared by Buna S rubber. Next, we discuss about preparation of butyl rubber. This is also one of the elastomer. Butyl rubber is also one of the elastomer. Next, it is also prepared by copolymerization of isobutylene with small amount of isoprene. Already I have told what is the addition polymerization. Same type of monomers are participated, but small molecules are not eliminated. What is the condensation polymerization? Different type of monomers are participated, small molecules are eliminated. What is the copolymerization? Different type of monomers are participated, but small molecules are not eliminated. So here also isobutylene and isoprene are different type of monomers. These are participated in copolymerization. Small molecules are not eliminated and butyl rubber is formed. Okay, butyl rubber is prepared by copolymerization of isobutylene and isoprene. Next, we discussed about the preparation reaction of butyl rubber by isobutylene and isoprene. What is the isobutylene means? This type of group is there, iso, CH3, like this is the angle shape, CH3, CCH3, this is the iso group. How many carbons present in this carbon compound? 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, iso type structure is there. 4 carbons is there. That's why this is the isobutylene. Next, we also take small amount of isoprene. Isoprene means here also this type of iso structure is there. CH2 double bond C, CH3. So this common name is isoprene. What is the IUPAC name? 1, 2, 3, 4. Second carbon contain methyl group. So 2-methyl, first and third carbons contain double bonds. 2-methyl, 1,3-butadiene, IUPAC name. A common name is isoprene. So this is also here also first to second. Second carbon contain methyl group. So 2-methyl. This first carbon contain double bond. 1-propene. 2-methyl. 1-propene. This contain 3 carbons. 1-methyl. Sorry, 2-methyl. 1-propene. Common name is isobutylene. This is 2-methyl. 1,3-butadiene. Common name is isoprene. Okay, these two are participated in copolymerization. What happened in the copolymerization means, okay, this double bond is broken. Here double bond is also broken. Here also double bond is broken. When these two double bonds broken, here double bond is formed. So this carbon contains single electron, this carbon contains single electron. When here also double bond is broken, these two carbons contain single electrons. So this CH3 comes here, this carbon forms bond with this carbon. So this carbon, this is the second carbon, here also second carbon forms bond with CH2. Next, this carbon forms bond with another isoprene molecule. Next, here also this carbon forms bond with another isobutylene molecule. So N molecules of isobutylene is participated, M molecules of isoprene is participated. Then butyl rubber is formed. Okay, butyl rubber is formed like this. This is the butyl rubber structure. Okay, next we discuss about uses of butyl rubber. It is used in making cycle tubes, automobile tubes. Already all of you know that tubes, cycle tubes, automobile tubes, these are prepared by butyl rubber. It is used in the making cycle tubes and automobile tubes. It is used in the manufacture of conveyor belts. Generally, conveyor belts are used in the motors. Those belts are prepared by butyl rubber. Okay, next, preparing tank linings. Tank linings, that means tanks are also prepared by butyl rubber. It is used in the insulation for high voltage wires. High voltage wires. That means generally plastic coating present on the wires. That plastic is also butyl rubber. It is used in making automobile parts. These are the uses of butyl rubber. Okay, butyl rubber is used in making cycle tubes and automobile tubes. Butyl rubber is used in the manufacture of conveyor belts. Butyl rubber is used in preparing tank linings. Next, butyl rubber is used insulation for high voltage wires. Butyl rubber is used making automobile parts. These are the uses of butyl rubber. Okay, we discussed about three types of elastomers. One is Bunais rubber, another one is neoprene, another one is butyl rubber. Okay, now we discussed about neoprene rubber, preparation of neoprene rubber. It is prepared by addition polymerization of chloroprene. Already I have explained same type of monomers are participated in addition polymerization without elimination of simple molecules. Next, different type of monomers are participated in condensation polymerization with elimination of simple molecules. Next, different type of monomers are participated in condensation polymer, sorry, in copolymerization without elimination of central molecules. So neoprene rubber is prepared by addition polymerization of chloroprene. Chloroprene is a 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. Structural formula of chloroprene is like this. This is the structural formula. Okay, listen. This is the chain. Common name is chloroprene. What is the IUPAC name means? You write numbering 1, 2, 3, next 4. Okay, this chlorine present on second carbon. This first carbon contain double bond. Next third carbon contain double bond. First carbon, third carbon contain double bonds. Okay, so what is the IUPAC name means? This is chlorine present on second carbon means 2-chloro. First and third carbons contain double bonds means 1,3. Total 4 carbons, buta, 2 double bonds means diene. 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. Okay, this is the reaction of preparation of neoprene. Okay, this is the chloroprene. This is 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. It is participated in addition polymerization. So N molecules combine together, then neoprene is formed. Okay, how the bonds formed between the molecules means you take another molecule, take here, then CH2. Cl, CH, CH, bond, CH2, CH2. Okay, this is the chloroprene. These are the two molecules of chloroprene. Here double bond is broken. Here double bond is broken. When double bond is broken, these two carbon contain single electrons. Here also, when double bond is broken, these two carbons also contain single electron. That means, okay, listen. Here, actually the structure is not correct. Here also double bond present. Okay, here also double bond present. Okay, listen. Here and here double bonds are broken. These two carbon contains single electrons. These two carbon contains single electrons. First, this electron form another bond. Here double bond is formed. So here double bond is formed. In this molecule also, these two double bonds are broken. All carbons contain single electron. This here double bond is formed. Next, this carbon forms bond with this carbon. This carbon form bond with another chloroprene molecule. This carbon also forms with bond with another chloroprene molecules. So, N molecules combine together by addition polymerization. Okay. Bonds are formed like this. Okay, next, we discuss about uses of neoprene rubber. Okay. It is used in making sponges, conveyor belts. Neoprene rubber is used in making sponges, conveyor belts, sponge type. Next, conveyor belts also prepared by neoprene rubber. These are all used. Neoprene rubber is used in linings of reaction vessels, adhesives. Neoprene rubber is used in linings of reaction vessels, adhesives. Neoprene rubber is used in the preparing gloves, aprons, and household articles. Preparing gloves, aprons, and household articles. Next, it is also used in wire insulation, cable coverings. Wire insulation and cable coverings. Next, it is also used in making hoses, gaskets, and tubing for carrying corrosive gases and oils. Carrying corrosive gases and oils. These are the uses of neoprene rubber. Okay, making sponges, conveyor belts, linings of reaction vessels, adhesives, preparing gloves, aprons, and household articles. Next, wire insulation, cable coverings. Next, making hoses, gaskets, and tubing for carrying corrosive gases and oils. These are the uses of neoprene rubber. Okay, this is the afran. This is the afran. This afran is prepared by neoprene rubber. Okay, these are the gloves. Gloves, these are also prepared by neoprene rubber. This is the gasket. Gasket means we are used without leaking of air, oil. One type of button we use, that button is the gasket. Okay, this is the gasket. This gasket is also prepared by neoprene rubber. Okay, gasket, this type of structure is there. Okay, next we discuss about general uses of rubber. General uses of rubber, already we discussed. Because of electrical resistance, it is used as insulating coating on wires and cables, used for electrical power transmission. Used for electrical power transmission. Because of electrical resistance, it is used as insulating coating on wires, cables, used for electrical power transmission. Due to its chemical resistance, it is used for making rubber lined metal tanks and vessel used in chemical industry. But due to its chemical resistance, it is used for making rubber lined metal tanks and vessel used in chemical industry. Because of its elasticity, it is used for making rubber bands, golf balls, printing rollers, tubes of automobiles, aeroplane, and bicycles. Okay, tubes of automobiles, aeroplanes, and bicycles. Because of its elasticity, you know that what are the rubber bands, golf balls, printing rollers, tubes of automobiles, all are prepared by artificial rubber. Next, due to its abrasion resistance, it is used for making bicycles, automobiles, and aeroplane tires, shoe soles, conveyor belt, shock absorbers. Okay, due to abrasion resistance, it is used for making bicycles, automobiles, and aeroplane tires, shoe soles, conveyor belt, shock absorbers. These are the general uses of artificial rubber. This is the general uses of artificial rubber. Artificial rubber. Okay. Because of electrical resistance, it is used as insulating coating on wires and cables, used for electrical power transmission. Due to its chemical resistance, it is used for making rubber lined metal tanks and vessel used in chemical industry. Because of its elasticity, it is used for making rubber bands, golf bands, printing rollers, tubes of automobiles, aeroplanes, and bicycles. Due to its abrasion resistance, it is used for making bicycles, automobiles, and aeroplane tires, shoe soles, conveyor belt, shock absorbers. Okay. Next we also discuss another general uses of artificial rubber. Next one, ebonite or hard rubber is used for storage battery cases, electricity switchboard panels, plugs and sockets, telephone receivers, etc. Ebonite or hard rubber is used for storage battery cases, electricity switchboard panels, plugs and sockets, telephone receivers, etc. All are prepared by the hard rubber or ebonite rubber. Next one, sponge rubber is used for shock absorption, water and sound absorption. Sponge rubber is used for shock absorption, water and sound absorption. Okay, shock no water and sound absorb cheyadam koraku sponge rubber no use chestam. Next, foam rubber is used for making mattresses, bed pillows, cushions, automotive pads, etc. Foam rubber is used for making mattresses, bed pillows, cushions, automotive pads, etc. Next, rubber is used as an extensive adhesive for repairing tubes of different vehicles. Rubber is used as an extensive adhesive for repairing tubes of different vehicles. Next, rubber gaskets are used for sealing cookers, refrigerator doors, autoclaves, etc. మనకి ఇక్కడ ఎయిర్ వాటర్ ఏది లీక్ కాకుండా ఉండడం కొరకు మన కుక్కర్స్, రిఫ్రిజిరేటర్ డోర్స్, ఆటోక్లేవ్స్ కు కొన్ని ఐటమ్స్ యూజ్ చేస్తూ దట్ ఐటమ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ గాస్కెట్. రబ్బర్ గాస్కెట్స్ ఆర్ యూజ్ ఫర్ సీలింగ్ కుక్కర్స్, రిఫ్రిజిరేటర్ డోర్స్, ఆటోక్లేవ్స్, ఎక్సెట్రా. నెక్స్ట్, ఇన్ మెడిసిన్ రబ్బర్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ మేకింగ్ హార్ట్ వాల్వ్స్, ట్రాన్స్ఫ్యూజన్ ట్యూబింగ్స్, sheeting for nerve repairs and padding for plastic surgery. Okay, in medicine, rubber is used for making heart valves, transfusion tubings, sheeting for nerve repairs and padding for plastic surgery. Okay. Next, rubber is used for making toys, sports goods, decorative articles, etc. Already we know that. Next, polysulfide rubber is used as propellant fuel in rocket engines. Polysulfide rubber is used as propellant fuel in rocket engines. These are the uses of rubber. Ebonite or hard rubber is used for storage battery cases, electricity switchboard panels, plugs and sockets, telephone receivers. Next, sponge rubber is used for shock absorption, water and sound absorption. Next, foam rubber is used for making mattresses, bed pillows, cushions, automotive pads, etc. Next, rubber is used as an extensive adhesive for repairing tubes of different vehicles. Rubber gaskets are used for sealing cookers, refrigerator doors, autoclaves, etc. In medicine, rubber is used for making heart valves, transfusion tubings, sheeting for nerve repairs and padding for plastic surgery. Next, rubber is used for making toys, sports goods, decorative articles, etc. Next, polysulfide rubber is used as propellant fuel in rocket engine. Next, we discuss about fiber. What is the fiber? What is the fiber means? Generally, fiber cloth, that is the nylon cloth or polyester cloth, based on nylon cloth or plastic cloth. What is the definition of fiber? Fiber means nylon cloth or plastic cloth, based on nylon cloth or polyester cloth. What is the definition of fiber means? Already you know that nylon cloth and polyester cloth. Okay, now we discuss the definition. A long filament of a homogeneous polymer having high tensile strength and high length to thickness ratio is called fiber. Okay, a long filament of a homogeneous polymer having high tensile strength, దట్ మీన్స్ ఎంత స్ట్రెచ్ చేసినా అది సాగుతుంది. నెక్స్ట్ హై లెంత్ టు థిక్నెస్ రేషియో, చాలా సన్నగా ఉండి చాలా లాంగ్గా ఉంటుంది, ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ఫైబర్. ఏ లాంగ్ ఫిలమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఏ హోమోజీనియస్ పాలిమర్ హ్యావింగ్ హై టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ అండ్ హై లెంత్ టు థిక్నెస్ రేషియో ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ఫైబర్. ద లెంత్ టు థిక్నెస్ రేషియో ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫైబర్ షుడ్ బి అట్లీస్ట్ 100%, 100% ఉండాలి. ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ టు థిక్నెస్, ద లెంత్ టు థిక్నెస్ రేషియో ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫైబర్ షుడ్ బి అట్లీస్ట్ 100%. ద పాలిమర్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫైబర్ ఈజ్ ఆర్గానిక్ ఆర్ మెటాలిక్ ఆర్ సెరమిక్ ఇన్ నేచర్. ద పాలిమర్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫైబర్ ఈజ్ ఆర్గానిక్ ఆర్ మెటాలిక్ ఆర్ సెరమిక్ ఇన్ నేచర్. Next, what are the characteristics of a fiber? It should have high tensile strength to produce stable fiber. Meganta stretch chesina sagutundi kabatti stable fiber form avutundi. It should have high tensile strength to produce stable fiber. Next, it should have sufficient resistance to light, heat and air oxidation. It should have sufficient resistance to light, heat and air oxidation. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ హై స్టిఫ్నెస్ అండ్ గుడ్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ. మనం ఎంత ఫోర్స్ అప్లై చేసినా అది హై స్టిఫ్నెస్ ఉంటుంది, గుడ్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ ఉంటుంది, కానీ బ్రిటిల్ అనేటువంటిది కాదు. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ హై స్టిఫ్నెస్ అండ్ గుడ్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ. నైలాన్ వైర్స్, నైలాన్ క్లాత్ మనం చూసినట్లయితే చాలా స్టిఫ్గా ఉంటుంది. ఇట్ లోయర్స్ టోటల్ డెన్సిటీ ఆఫ్ కాంపోజిట్స్. ఇట్ లోయర్స్ టోటల్ డెన్సిటీ ఆఫ్ కాంపోజిట్స్. It should be able to take fast colors. It should be able to take fast colors. Different colors lo manaku polyester cloth, nylon cloth anetundi available ga untundi. So what are the characteristics of a fiber? It should have high tensile strength to produce stable fiber. It should have sufficient resistance to light, heat and air oxidation. That means koda heat chesina dan paina ekko light vadda air tho oxidation aina అది కొద్దిగా సఫిషియంట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అంటే అంత ఈజీగా వాటికి బెండ్ కాదు, లైట్, హీట్ అండ్ ఎయిర్ ఆక్సిడేషన్. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ హై స్టిఫ్నెస్ అండ్ గుడ్ ఎలాస్టిసిటీ. ఇట్ లోయర్స్ టోటల్ డెన్సిటీ ఆఫ్ కాంపోజిట్స్. ఇట్ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు టేక్ ఫాస్ట్ కలర్స్. డిఫరెంట్ కలర్స్ మనకు నైలాన్, ప్లాస్టిక్ క్లాత్ అవైలబుల్గా ఉంటుంది. ద ఫైబర్స్ ఆర్ న్యాచురల్, ఎగ్జాంపుల్ కాటన్, సిల్క్, ఊల్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద న్యాచురల్ ఫైబర్స్. కాటన్, సిల్క్, ఊల్ are the natural fibers. Okay, next, semi-synthetic, rayon, cellulosic. Only synthetic fiber is nylon 66, Decron. This is the nylon 66 and Decron. Okay, we discuss about fibers. Okay, first we discuss about preparation and uses of fibers. Preparation and uses of fibers. First one, preparation of nylon 66. This is the one of the fiber. It is prepared by the condensation polymerization of adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine. So it is a thermosetting plastic. Okay, already we know that what is the condensation polymerization. Different monomers are participated with elimination of simple molecules is called condensation polymerization. So here also two different monomers are participated. One is adipic acid, another one is hexamethylene diamine. Okay, these two are participated in condensation polymerization. Then how the bonds are formed means here OH, this you also write NH like this, H, NH. So H2O is eliminated, then carbon form bond with NH, then nylon 66 is formed. So here also this NH also form bond with another adipic acid. Here also this OH also form bond with another hexamethylene diamine. Okay, this is the preparation. Okay, Lisa. Okay. This is the adipic acid, this is the hexamethylene diamine. These two are different monomers. These two are participated in condensation polymerization. When condensation polymerization, These two are participated in condensation polymerization. Then H2O molecule is eliminated. Then carbon form bond with NH. Here also form bond with another NPK acid. Here also OH form bond with another hexamethylene dimer molecule. So nylon 66 is formed. Okay, this is the preparation of nylon 66. Okay. And next we discuss about uses of nylon 66. It is used in making fabrics, carpets, tire cords, ropes, etc. It is used in making fabrics, carpets, tire cords, ropes, etc. It is used for making socks, dress materials, electrical connections, etc. It is used for making socks, dress materials, electrical connections, etc. It is used in making parachutes. It is waterproof in nature, so it is also used to make swimwear. Okay, generally swimwear or swim dresses are prepared by nylon cloth. Okay, what are the uses of nylon 66? It is used in making fabrics. Okay, we know that fabrics, carpets, tire cords, ropes. We call it as ropes or nylon thread. It is used for making socks. Socks are also prepared by nylon cloth. Dress materials, electrical connections, etc. It is used in making parachutes. Parachutes suda matha nylon tone prepared avutundi. It is waterproof in nature, so it is also used to make swim wear. Okay, next we discuss about preparation of polyester. Already you know that polyester cloth. It is also prepared by the condensation polymerization of ethylene glycol and terephthalate acid in the presence of a weak base. Already you know that condensation polymerization means different monomers are participated. Ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid are different monomers. When these different monomers are participated in condensation polymerization, simple molecules are eliminated like H2O. Okay. This polyester is prepared by the condensation polymerization of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid in presence of a weak base. When these two are participated in condensation polymerization, H2O molecule is eliminated like this. This is the OH. Here also H2O is eliminated like this. Next, this carbon form bond with this oxygen. Next, here also OH form bond with another ethylene glycol. Here also OH H form bond with another terephthalic acid. Okay, then H2O molecules are eliminated. These molecules are condensed. Then polyester is formed. This is about the preparation of polyester. Okay, it is prepared by the condensation polymerization of ethylene glycol terephthalic acid in the presence of weak base. Polyethylene terephthalate, common name is terlin or decron. Okay, this common name is polyester. Name is polyethylene terephthalate. Common name is terlin cloth or decron cloth. Okay, this is the PET. Also, it is also PET. This is the PET. Okay, next, we discuss about uses of polyethylene terephthalate. It is used for the manufacture of garments and dresses, polyester dresses, terlin dresses, decron dresses are also available in the market. So it is used for the manufacture of garments and dresses. It is also used as gloss reinforcing material in aircrafts, battery bones, etc. Battery bones, aircrafts lo gloss reinforcing material lo sir. It is also used as gloss reinforcing material in aircrafts, battery bones, etc. These are the uses of polyethylene terephthalate. Okay, we discussed about two type of fibers. One is nylon 66, another one polyester. That name is terephthalene, polyethylene terephthalate. Let me summarize this video lesson. What we have discussed in this video lesson, we learnt about what are the elastomers, preparation of Bunais rubber, uses of Bunais rubber. Next, we have also discussed about preparation of butyl rubber, uses of butyl rubber, preparation of neoprene rubber, uses of neoprene rubber. Okay. Next, discussed about some multiple choice questions. Elastomers are A, natural rubbers, B, artificial rubbers, C, thermoplastics, D, thermosetting plastics. Generally, elastomers are artificial rubbers. That we have discussed. All elastomers are artificial rubbers. What is the first synthetic rubber? What is the first synthetic rubber? That is GR1 rubber or butyl rubber. GR1 rubber or butyl rubber. This is the first synthetic rubber. Okay, B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. Next, another question. The Na in Bunais indicates native rubber, sodium used as catalyst, nitrogen used as catalyst, sodium used as antioxidant. Okay, in Bunais rubber, Bu indicates butadiene, Na indicates sodium. In earlier days, sodium is used as catalyst. S indicates styrene. Okay, Bu indicates butadiene. Na indicates sodium. In earlier days, sodium used as catalyst. S indicates styrene. So our answer is B. B. Sodium used as catalyst. Okay, the formula of styrene is CH2 double bond CH2, CH2 double bond CHCl, CH2 double bond CH, C6H5, CH2 double bond CH, CN. The formula of styrene, already you know that contain benzene ring, C6H5, CH double bond CH2. So C is the correct answer. C6H5, CH double bond CH. Next, another question. The formula of butadiene, CH2 double bond CHCl, CH2 double bond CH C6H5, CH2 double bond CH CN, CH2 double bond CH bond CH double bond CH. Butadiene means it contains 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 2 double bonds. So diene, so C is the correct answer, butadiene. The formula of butadiene is this one, C. Next, Bunais obtained by copolymerization of ethylene and styrene, butadiene and ethylene, vinyl chloride and styrene, butadiene and styrene. Okay, Bunais rubber is prepared by copolymerization of butadiene and styrene. So D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Bunais obtained by copolymerization of butadiene and styrene. D is the correct answer. Another one, isobutylene on copolymerization with isoprene forms Bunais, neoprene, butyl rubber, PVC. Okay, isobutylene on copolymerization with isoprene forms butyl rubber. C is the correct answer. C is the correct answer. Isobutylene on copolymerization with isoprene forms butyl rubber. So what we have discussed in this video lesson on the topics, some questions are asked frequently in the examination. That is the first one, define elastomers, give some examples. Next, explain the preparation of BuNOS rubber. Next, write any two uses of BuNOS rubber. Okay, some more questions are also asked. That is, explain preparation and uses of butyl rubber. Explain the preparation and uses of neoprene. Write any two uses of butyl rubber and neoprene. And also ask some questions on fiber. Define fiber. Write the characteristics of fiber. And also write preparation and uses of neoprene. And also write preparation and uses of polyester. Thank you for the listening of this video lesson.